Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome to the Halloween special, I guess, right? Of Sketchy Game Sesh. I say Halloween special even though it's, I don't know, 3 weeks, 2 weeks away from Halloween when I'm recording this, but gotta get it out early. I am hoping to get the whole Let's Play done, posted by Halloween for you guys. But just a little heads up about this. This is Alan Wake, the original. It's not the remaster. I know it's out, but hey, I'm on a budget. And second of all, I already own this on PC through GOG. I own it through Epic, and I own it on the original 360. I have played through this fully on the 360 several times, actually. So I just didn't feel the need to rebuy it. But I went ahead and put some mods, not really mods, some reshades on here. So I'll show that to you once we're in game, once, you know, it slows down a bit. But basically I just made it a bit darker, the contrast is a bit stronger, just to give it a bit better look if I could. But we're gonna go ahead and start a new game. Like I said, I have played this, but it's been, I don't know, 5, maybe even 6 years since I last played it. So we're gonna play it on normal. I wish I could play it on nightmare. That'd be nice.
Stephen
since
King
I have
once
played
wrote
it.
That nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Oh.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
I'll say.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone.
This intro, by the way, guys, always...
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Sorry. This intro always reminds me, and this might date me a little, but y'all remember I Know What You Did Last Summer? Where I think that's what happens, right? Oh, look up. Wrist control, no. You can change the camera settings. All right, I got that. Yeah, I think that's sort of what happens in I Know What You Did Last Summer, right? Where they run over somebody, throw them off the side, and craziness happens after that.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Alright guys, so I guess here's a good time to show you, and just mostly because I'm starting to have doubts myself. I didn't install the reshade. This is what's on there. Let me see. Active to top. Put a smart sharp. It makes it a little bit sharper, as you can see. I don't know if you can tell. Makes it a bit blurrier. I don't know how YouTube is going to compress this, but on my end, it's noticeable. Then I did this. Yeah, now mine is, I think, better. So that's default without it. This is with it on. Then you have this, so I see that it's got like a little blue tint on my end. This kind of takes it off a little bit. But mostly the darks are darker. contrast is a bit up, but the whites are very strong. I might have to turn that down, but I won't make you guys go through that. Anyways, let's get to it. I am playing mouse and keyboard. I've never played mouse and keyboard on this game, but my
you don't even recognize me,
my muscle memory's been a bit better.
You think you're God? You think you could just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think
you're
into the drama.
Thought it couldn't get me in the light.
You're in this story now. I'll make you suffer. You're a joke. You would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories. Cause I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any
good.
Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and
pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Forget your work.
You got a QR code. Feel free to scan it if you want. What's that? A scuba diver on the left? Let's head out. But if this is a dream, I mean, it's a little on the nose, right? Spaces jump. Alright.
You missed your deadline!
Dodge enemy attacks with a shift in this side. Oh, that's not how you do that.
You can't stop me!
Where to go.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Almost thought that was a collectible right there. It's a little too shiny.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
I'm not dead yet, bro. Hold down shift to sprint. Look at him run. Great animation. Like an old man trying to run. Oh, look at that.
Hurry!
That's literally this holding down shift, by the
Over
way.
Here!
You don't gotta tell me twice.
Oh no!
Maybe we just left him out there. You're on your own, bud.
Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
It's cool, yeah, it's just my dream, so that's just a dream character, he ain't real. No way out, huh? What is up with that? Die? Get to the lighthouse, how do I get there though? Oh,
the cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
I don't think there is a way out, though. Oh, maybe
Follow
there is.
The light.
Into the light. You are only safe there.
Going to the safe haven. Heaven Haven. Alright.
You must go into the light.
Stay until you are completely healed. Oh, there
well
we go.
Done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this.
Are you God?
I did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies
maybe I shouldn't look directly at it, huh?
Green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow
my life. I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Mm-hmm.
This way. There's no time.
Sorry, you guys. Just forgot. Let's go ahead and set a timer again, like always.
You must follow me now. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
I was about to say, they gave me revolver ammo, no gun.
Take the flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Right. Right mouse does that.
You did it.
Insert batteries,
now
Q.
The darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Thank you. Now I can shoot him, right? Bam. Bam, bam, bam. Really? How many was that? 5 shots? 6 shots?
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Alright, thank you.
In the nightmare, a terrible
light Jesus
was taken over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
So, I do remember some of this stuff, obviously.
You made me this way,
they teach you to like aim at them like this, and it'll make their darkness disappear quicker, but if you can get away with it, you don't have to. You can just point the flashlight at them. And it makes your batteries drain slower. So, little pro tip there. I use that a lot. You just gotta rely more on the dodging at that point.
This is it, witch.
Of course, if you're surrounded, you might want to. And it does knock them back a bit when you first do that. What do you got in here? Flare gun, nice. Flare gun ammo, nice. More ammo. Flares are some of my favorite things in this game, by the way. Yep. This way. Nope, nothing here. So I might pause it every now and then, guys. I want to show you, like, let me know if I'm tripping. I do want to check how YouTube compresses this. Is it better? See, that's sharper to me. And the brightness, way better. The tint, this one, not super noticeable right now. But if it looks better one way or the other and I get comments or anything, let me know. I'll change it. Alright, let's just flare these guys. All dead. Flares are like I said, one of my favorite items. You can even use them to just... It's like an AoE effect, I think. Get out of here, bro. Who said that? Can we just leave him? Yeah, let's just leave him. Oh.
I can keep this up.
Got a tornado. Now some of these items, you can fight this, it doesn't look like it. Might as well run. Oh, what the heck? I hate how he runs, by the way. This feels so slow to me. I feel like an old dude running. Cap changes the way you're looking, but doesn't do much here. Yeah, we're gonna make it, we're good. This way, right? Here.
Shh, baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Great lip syncing, huh?
We're here.
By the way, I might hate on aspects of this game, but keep in mind, this is one of my favorite games ever. I've played this, like I said, multiple times. I just love the whole feeling of it. The gameplay is great, obviously. But I'm a big Stephen King fan also. So this just fits exactly what I like. I'm big on horror. And I mentioned Stephen King because, I mean, yeah, he mentioned it himself earlier. But this has big Stephen King vibes and I love it. I mean, even the name Bright Falls, that I could imagine that as one of the towns in a Stephen King novel.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
By the way,
sure.
One of my favorite
give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Yep. One of my favorite Stephen King novels, Under the Dome. If you haven't read that, check it out. The show sucks. The book or novel is great.
Picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Alan Wake is kind of a douchebag every now and then, by the way. Good graphics though, right? I mean, when did this game come out? I might have to Google this for you guys. Let me see real quick. When did I first play this? I played this pretty soon after it came out. saying here 2010. Wow. So I'm playing through Red Dead Redemption, which also came out in 2010. I guess 2010 was a good year for me.
What? Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right.
Ooh, got a little glitchy there.
Yeah. Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make
sure. Settling in? We haven't even gotten to the place yet.
Okay?
My editor's already here, like, yo, you writing the next big novel for me? I'm trying to make some money here.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Y'all see that deer over there? Deerfest is getting ready. We're here, get back in the car. Alright.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Microsoft Sync, huh? Brought to you by Microsoft.
I love you,
Sync.
Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Is that still a thing?
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Mm-hmm.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Doesn't that lady give you guys a...
Try the coffee.
Misery
Just
vibes?
Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
No, I'm good.
Are you on your own?
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. Ha!
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your
it
sleep.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Yes, that's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented has-been.
I wasn't paying attention there. What happened?
Shut it for
what is
you.
Going on?
Jeez.
Oh, it's the... I'm hitting E.
Tune number 6 in the jukebox. Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
So, low-key, these side characters, not necessarily them two, but like the side characters in this game are some of my favorite things in this game. Even like this lady over here, watch.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find
you
Stuckey
don't want
to,
die, to
get the key
you.
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans
listen.
Always did.
Yeah, look at the waitress over there just checking me out.
I told Rose last week that She should change the bowl. This is what happens when you get sloppy.
This lady knows something we don't, huh? Go to the girls' bathroom. Nope, doesn't let me.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Not creepy at all.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
That lady gives me Silent Hill vibes, by the way. And yeah,
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Crazy lady, but she knows what she's talking about.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn, aren't you? It swells up like a balloon if I lift it anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, the Andersons. They're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Mm-hmm. All right, Ann Wilkes. I'll see you later.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Yep.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Smart.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
I guess we're going to the wrong place, huh?
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation.
Mr. Stucky got a little drunk or what?
Let's get back home.
Okay. We just knocked him out.
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
Dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
So I know I mentioned this already, but... Well, not entirely, but Misery by Stephen King. I haven't read the novel, by the way. But the movie, great shit. And this has strong vibes of that. Writer with writer's block. Goes into a small town to get some inspiration. Crazy shit happens. Of course, not as crazy as Alan Wake, but still really good. Bird Leg Cabin? What it said? Bird Leg Cabin. Alright. Let's go, wifey. Good graphics, though. I mean, I know I upscaled it a tiny bit, but I mean, ignore these really bad. bushes down here, or not bushes, what is it, like hay? I don't even know. Shrubbery?
Here we go.
Whatever.
Let's take a look inside.
But the visuals are good. Maybe not the graphics, the visuals are good.
Come on.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Maybe.
Hello? Anyone here?
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phone.
This guy said he wasn't going to say a word.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
All right, let's find the... power box, whatever you call it. I don't know what it's called. Isn't it usually in the basement? Is this gonna be in the attic?
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Oh, whoa.
Damn. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s. Or even earlier. I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
Fuse box, that's what I was looking for. The word earlier. So, somewhere on the island. I'm assuming he means not specifically inside the cabin. What's this?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, who is Thomas Zane? Maybe it's this way, huh? Nah, they wouldn't put a fuse box there or a power generator, right? I'm not joking around, by the way, guys. I really don't even know where this is. Get the power on. Okay, well... give me a clue.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Thank you. I was literally just asking for that.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
I guess that's not how you do that.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Cut you off there.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Perhaps.
I thought we could be happy here.
Maybe. Good atmosphere though, look at this. I mean, it's creepy as heck, but for a game, this is good atmosphere. Was that?
Alice?
Was that there, honey? The whole time?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make.
I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You... Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Damn it. Alice?
Gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice! I'm coming! It's all right! I'm coming!
Oh, what the hell? What the hell was that?
What the hell?
Am I going the right way? I don't know.
Alice? Alice? Oh no!
From one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Stuckies? Y'all remember Stucky, right? And how the hell did we get here?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there. Damn.
Well, that car's gone, huh? I do have this on headphones, by the way, guys. The atmosphere is pretty good. I don't know if my voice is killing it for you guys, but if you can put on some headphones, put them on real quick, check this out.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
F5 for manuscripts. The title page.
By Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
That's good writing. I mean, I could literally picture that on a novel or a book. Maybe not necessarily a Stephen King novel, but definitely a book. Oh, controls are a bit sensitive on the mouse.
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident!
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
This game does reward you for exploring like this, by the way, guys. But I don't know if I'm gonna be doing too much of that on this play session gameplay on this, because I put it really dark. It's not like it wouldn't be really dark to begin with, but oh, I'm going off to the side. I mean, we'll do what we can, don't worry.
Anybody there?
I like to be thorough to
Please.
Begin with.
I've been in an accident.
I like how he calls out, "Yo, I've been in an accident, help me out." Some creepy shit going on. "Yo, I've been in an accident."
Hey! Hey, you!
Failed!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Oh snap, it's my boy Stucky. Where the hell is he? Wait, where'd he go? And what is this? Oh, manuscript page. Let's read that real quick before,
the taken stood before
Stucky
me.
Kills us.
It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Brighter, huh? That might just come in handy. If I had a flashlight. Oh, what the hell? Alright. This way? Nope.
Right.
It's the lady!
Great! I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
I think you already did that, bro. More Stephen King references, by the way. Want to switch weapon throwables, huh? I don't have any other weapons. Unless this is... Nope, batteries. Pick me up some Duracells. This game is brought to you by Duracell, by the way.
During your... Trying...
Yes.
It's the latest.
Right,
Ball
Sheriff Station.
Only
a...
Hello?
Woman! This guy just cut the power line.
This is bad.
Oh crap, let's get out of here. Whoa. Well, that's gone. I don't know if I should trust that, but...
Never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
I heard something over there. What did that do? Maybe nothing.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
So yeah, this game has a lot of like little crannies, nooks and crannies that you can get into. Find some collectibles, some secrets. So, I think we're gonna be doing a little bit of that, by the way, guys.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
That's pretty cool. Look at that. Flare gun? I'll take that. Alright, quick stop here, guys. Let's see. How does this compare, though? Let me see. Turn that off. A little bit more blue. Yeah, look at the blacks. And the sharpness. A little bit sharper. Yeah, I think we're gonna keep it for now. We'll see. If I wanna make the blacks blacker, we will later. I'm trying to make this as spooky as I can. I did put up the game volume for you guys a little bit also. I'm hoping that, you know, the game audio itself is gonna be creepy, even for you guys. It's not the scariest game, it's very action, but it is creepy, spooky. Excuse me. Which way am I supposed to go? Reach the gas station. What did I miss? I feel like I'm missing something though. It's probably that way. Or maybe this. No, that tells me to go that way. That tells me to go that way. Yeah, I guess it would be that way though. Well, why can't I go anywhere else after that? Or am I doing something wrong there? Once we're here, what then? Okay, so this might be an issue. Not exactly clear on where to go. See, so once you can't go that way, you would assume, okay, maybe I go this way, right? And then I think you would be right. And I was just being dumb. And then you can't go that way. Can't go that way either. What am I missing, guys? Am I being dumb? You tell me. That way? Is this... It shouldn't be this hard, right? Tell me to go to the gas station. But which way is that? This is horrible, y'all. Maybe this way? Can I climb this somehow? Oh, it was this way. Wow. Checkpoint reached. Did I just throw something at me? Got some batteries, some ammo. Alright, before we go. So light and shadow have a lot to do in this game, and I can see this from pretty far away. Manuscript page. Let's read that.
The taking stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it.
Wait, we already read that. Oh, it's this one.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Oh, am I missing some stuff? Missing page here. Did I skip a bunch of stuff? Is that how that works? And can I exit all that even quicker than hitting escape every single time? I don't know, we'll find this all out. But yeah, you can find manuscript pages, ammo, all sorts of crazy stuff. If you explore a little bit. Probably that way. Nothing this way, let's go. Okay.
What the hell was that?
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
So it kind of like predicts what's gonna happen. So Barry is gonna be joining us. I like that though, because you know, once that happens, you're gonna be like, oh, I remember I heard about that. Who? What?
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
So I'm pretty sure it's that way, but that means we're headed this way. Nothing over here. Except some cool scenery. I mean, look at this. I think that's where we came from, right? Oh, that guy just threw something at me. These assholes. Oh, this guy. I dodged into that one. Uh-oh. Alright, my dodge is a bit off, so we're gonna have to practice that a bit more. But tapping shift and then like a direction? I don't know. I was considering doing this on the controller, but the flashlight is just so much better right here, obviously, right? And like I said, I've played this on the controller several times now, so it's time we do this on the mouse. All right, which way do I go? I do wonder if, like, how dark I set it is gonna impede my ability to progress in this game. But I hope not. I think they make it clear enough most of the time. Like, I think it should be this way. Right, yeah. Let's say caution, protected something. Proceed at your own risk. Logging area ahead. So I'm guessing we're supposed to head that way. So we're headed this way instead. The lights are telling me to go up here.
Taken. They're taken.
Let's say the taken filled with darkness. The taken filled with darkness. All right. So we found a hidden cache. So this also reminds me of another book I've recently been currently reading, actually, called, it's in Spanish. It's a book by a Spanish author, Spanish as in Spaniard from Spain, called La Sombra del Viento, or The Shadow of the Wind. If you've read The Shadow of the Wind, good shit. But basically, it's about a writer that, you know, he suffers through some crazy stuff, and the characters in his story start coming to life. Maybe not exactly that, but, you know, one of the protagonists is like, this guy kind of seems like a book, not a book, a character from the book. So it has a little bit of that too. I recommend it too. It's pretty good.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Okay. So I've been reading in Spanish just because I'm trying to get my Spanish vocabulary and grammar on point. But I've heard that in English it's pretty good also. Revolver, we're full. All right.
I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
So there's a strategy to, like, how you shoot, how you charge, how you aim, all of that. Oh, I forget. Alright, good minigames.
Before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came, I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Nice. Alright, so resume is F5. Okay. That's a lot easier. Shotgun, nice. Only 2 bullets though? Wow. Alright, let's save that for later though. Am I missing anything? Alright, actually, let me pause here, guys. Quick second. Alright, sorry guys. Back. So, I just checked the timer. Shoot, did I lose that? We're basically at an hour now. I am thinking these episodes, I want them to be at least 2 hours. You guys hear that? Anyways. Yeah, I want them to be at least 2 hours long, because I'm trying to do this. I think the whole game should be like, I don't know, 12, 14 hours. So if we could do like 6, 7 episodes, maybe 8, that'd be good. Now, It can be longer if we're doing what I'm doing. So that might change, but that's the idea for now. I need to figure out what those coffee thermos do. We turned on something over here, right? Wasn't it this? I think now I'm going backwards. It was this right here. There we go. Move the log lift. I think that's good. Right there. Climb right there. Nice. Not necessarily the most complex puzzles, but it does have a little bit of that. I see the light over there, but again, let's check the perimeter for stuff like this. Which one's that?
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
All right. I think that's the correct way, actually, but we didn't go into the light. I think that was just not necessarily like a hidden page, but something I was supposed to find to begin with. This seems more hidden. Look at this old-timey truck right here. Nice little hidden cache. Some more flare gun ammo. Well, it said flare gun, but since we already have it, I'm guessing it's just ammo, right? Anything down there? I'm thinking these are just checkpoints, right? That's what this is. We're falling. Checkpoint reach, yep.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and don't keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Well, Toby's gone, huh? It'd be cool if we run into Toby, actually. Imagine that. We're out here and we see a little doggy. Would I have to shoot it? It's like possessed by darkness. That would suck. Hopefully not. I love doggies, by the way, so...
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no contest. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
He said the famous dog, right? Oh no, not Toby. What? I think we're about to fall into the next area. All right, let's do it. Oh boy, I did not mean to switch weapons there, but that worked out perfectly. What the hell? Oh wow, really? Ooh. All right, let's take a quick little breather from all that. I think this is the new one, right? That's how it works, right? The one with the question mark?
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
All right. So we gotta make our way up there, but of course we gotta go the opposite way. So it sounds like we're gonna run into a crazy Alan Wake. What are you trying to get? I don't know if they're endless, by the way, guys. Like, they'll keep spawning if I'm out here. Oh man, really? Wow. Alright, let's just finish this area before we head out. A generator. Ooh, save point, nice. I mean, we just started this game, but you can see why I love this, right? It's just tense as hell. And I like how the gameplay, like, you have to be reactive, you know, you gotta be dodging, a little bit of strategy, sometimes you wanna use your battery, sometimes you don't. Music might be a bit too high though. It's getting a little too out of control for me. Let me see. Put it, let's try that. Alright, that's a little better. I'm guessing we're supposed to go up. But we're gonna go down. Proceed at your own risk, huh? It's not my intention, but let's see how far we can get without dying, yo. That'd be cool. Plus, it might add a bit of tension. 3? Alright. Alright, one thing about this though, I think I am headed the right way. So, we're gonna head the wrong way now. Okay, so arrows don't necessarily mean it's the correct way, it just means probably a cache somewhere. There it is. Is that it? What the hell is up with this? Okay. Got us a little poltergeist Indiana Jones up here. So obviously it's that way, right? But it looks like we can explore over here. Oh, maybe not. I almost fell off. That's what's making that noise?
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's see what's inside this room. Lithium batteries were good. Oh.
It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode. Quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not
happen. Snap. Someone unplug that.
Insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools. Gaze upon quantum immortality.
Poor Dr. Colvin.
Yikes.
Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
You're about to enter the scary door. If you get that reference, let me know. And if you know, you know. If you don't know, then psh, I don't know if we could be friends. But obviously, Twilight reference. Oh man, this just hits so many good stuff for me. I love Twilight. The Twilight Zone. Twilight reference. Twilight Zone. I love the Twilight Zone. I love Stephen King. Scary books, scary movies, creepy stuff, science fiction. So dope. Yeah, this game was definitely made for people like me. Anyways, let's get some more action. Why is it so creepy all of a sudden? Checkpoint reached. And I'm not even in a bright zone. That's not good. Where are you, Stucky? I will kill you. Maybe I shouldn't walk under. Oh! I was gonna say, maybe I shouldn't walk under that. I'm not ready for it at all. Let's get up. Oh. I'm a bit stingy with some of my good weapons, so. F you, Stucky.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Yep. Alright, well, now that Stucky's dead. I think. I hope. Let's freely explore this cool little area here. Got another thermos here. What are these for? What do they do? I might have to Google that. So far I don't know the use. If I could find another manuscript page in here, that'd be cool. I wish it told you, like, yo, you found all of them in this area or not, you know? But that might be a form of cheating, I guess. Not necessarily, right? Just a way of being thorough. But we're making our way up there. But, alright, I don't see much else. Let's get out of here. Looks like we took care of Stucky already. Cool nickname, by the way. What is... okay. Oh, look at that deer we saw earlier. Look how far this flashlight can reach. That's freaking cool.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Yes, I did. I think we are supposed to go that way, so of course let's go this way. Nothing over here. The wreck car over here. Look at that.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil.
A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Wow, so that's how Stucky met his end.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Yeah, what the hell? That's interesting. I don't remember that at all. I wonder if that gets explained or it's just one of those.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Yeah, I wonder if they explain why we're missing a week or it's just one of those, crazy mysteries. Can I explore anywhere else? More thermos, huh? I really am gonna have to look up what these thermos mean. Looks like we can already start heading that way, but... Alright, let's check the...
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to
call
for help.
Gas station for sure. I know, Alan Wake, I know, but... I like to be thorough, my friend. Okay. Oh, look at this guy. Oh, really? Oh, these guys are kicking my butt. They were, at least were pretty easy to, you know, undarken? I don't know what would be the term. I don't know. To reveal? Oh, really, dude? Oh man, did that guy look like he was wearing some Halloween skeleton costume or something like that to you guys, like it did to me? Oh man, am I gonna explore? How's my health? I think my health's alright. Yeah, see, this is why a mouse is way better. I could just swirl around like this. Oh yeah. Take this mouth flippers. There we go. Who's alive? None of you are alive, right? Oh, I guess, yeah. Oh my god. I'm about to die. Oh no. There goes our perfect run, everybody. Alright, so... Alright, let's secure the...
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place. Or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Alright. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this.
It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
A little bit. So that's exactly like one of those manuscript pages said, right? He saw himself talking crazy. Alright, the 68th annual Deer Fest is on September 15th and 18th. My birthday's on September 19th, by the way, guys. Save that on your calendar for next year. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, and surprise competitions, live music, cool. for the children, Bucktooth Charlie, huh? And Montgomery, the Mystic's Amazing Phantasmagoria. Okay. Don't miss the legendary Deerfest Parade. Cool. Nordic walking. Incontestably proven health benefits. Incontestably. Wow. I can't read. Even though I can't read sometimes, you know? Can I go this way, though? Oop, wrong way. This way. Nope. Gotta go back the way you came. We didn't pick up that manuscript page? Same one, right? Yeah, I can't see him.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Wait, what do you mean? We were already in there. Did I miss something in there? Oh, I heard something, right? Y'all heard it, right? Oh, there we go. There's a phone.
Great Ball Sheriff Station.
Done. We beat the game, y'all. It's been fun. Oh,
thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Oh no. Did I just... soft lock myself from the area I was exploring earlier?
Colored clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night.
Just a sprinkle. Let me just make some noise so that this doesn't register everything into that one thing. Every now and then, blah 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 blah. Enter skip.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice!
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Quick little aside, y'all. I didn't even remember that there was chapters to this. Are we gonna have to do this by chapter? Oh man, that might work out. That might be good. Let me see here real quick. Alan Wake Chapters. How many are there? Blah, blah, blah. How long is Alan Wake? All right. Cool, cool. Collectible playthroughs. There's 6 chapters. Can we do this in 6 chapters, y'all? Maybe, right? Obviously. 6 episodes, 6 chapters. That sounds good. The only problem, though, can I replay some of these? Because I do kind of want to go into that area where I missed it. So bear with me. We might have to see this twice up until I figure out if we can go back. Actually, can we save? I think, does it autosave? Quit to menu? Are you sure you want to quit? Let's risk it. Let's risk it. We're not doing those yet. I haven't done those.
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
They leave you way back here. What do you guys think? Should we, play through all that just to get to right before I accidentally soft locked myself? Nah, I think we're good. Let's just continue. If you guys like it, I'm down to do a hardcore mode. But ooh, it's very tempting. Anyways, yeah, we'll end this one here. We'll decide what we do on the next one. I'll let you guys know. But thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next episode. Don't forget to hit comment. No, not hit comment. Hit like. Don't forget to comment. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notifications if you want to. It's completely up to you. I wouldn't do it, but I'm not you. Anyways, see you on the next one. Thanks for watching. I've already said that, haven't I? Anyways. I'm just, killing time, wasting time, slowing down. Nah. I'm just trying to get my stupid OBS thing to work. There it is. Okay. Thank you for watching. See you on the next one. Peace.